in multi-level queue, what we are going to do, we are going to bifurcate our ready queue. So let's see how it works. Ready queue is partitioned into separate queues. Why we are separating ready queue into multiple queues? We want to try to implement our CPU scheduling algorithm on different queues on different manner. Suppose if we put in one section high priority processes and low priority processes in another queue, so that we can give some, as we know that in interactive processes we need frequent switches between processes. So for this, which CPU scheduling algorithm work better, it is round robin. And this manner we can achieve that flexibility. So let's see how we are bifurcating this ready queue. We are having a foreground, that is interactive process. Foreground is what? As you can see me, that I am, my face is in my foreground and my background there is a wall, right? So but which is interacting with you, foreground or background? Background is your batch process. Background is your batch process. Foreground is your interactive process. Means in foreground, like if you talk about this computer system, that your application programs, what are your application program that are interactive processes that are running in the foreground of your system, and what are the background processes? Now let me have an example of your WhatsApp. Suppose you are not using your phone right now, there is a net is on, it is putting on a table, but there is a notification light comes, then you can understand that there is a notification from WhatsApp or any other application. How it is? Because you are not using WhatsApp right now, you are not using your phone, but there are background services are running which are looking for a new notification in your WhatsApp. Right, so whenever a new message arrives in your WhatsApp or any other like Truecaller or somewhere else, then they give you a notification with the help of background services. So they are running in the background. So they, you are not so much interested in background services because they are running in the background. I suppose in my backside there is a wall. Maybe I am sitting in another room, there is a curtain behind, but you are not bothered about what are the background processes are running in my background. But you are much interested in my interaction. That is what I am telling you, what are the concept of this multi-level queue. So now this is how we are by forgetting the processes nature. One is of interactive nature and another one is batch, means in background processes we can send them. That is, low priority process can be sent to the background and high priority process can be sent to the foreground. So this is how ready queue is partitioned into separate queues. Now each queue has its own scheduling algorithm. We can, as we have bifurcated our ready queue into foreground and background, then we can implement our scheduling algorithm on each queue separately. So for foreground, which one is suitable? This is round robin, because in foreground we need interactive processes. It means we have to continuously switch between processes. And for background, this is first come, first serve. Let me give you another example of background process. Suppose I have before my class, this 9 a.m. class, I am working on my MS Word document. I am writing something, but as the time comes of my class of 9 a.m., I have opened my PowerPoint presentation, I have opened my Zoom application and my headphone, and still that Microsoft Word application is open, but I am not interacting with that Microsoft Word application right now. So what our intelligent operating system will do, that will send that MS Word document into background, means you are not interacting with that low priority process right now. You are interested in the this PowerPoint presentation and your Zoom application which is running concurrently and with this headphone. So that another application that I was using previously, which was in the foreground before starting this class, now it has been sent into the background by the operating system because I am not interacting with that MS Word document. So you can think of that this partition of a queue, like interactive process and your batch process, can be switched among those queues so that they have a flexible system and can allot much higher run time of these applications which I am currently using. So this is how each queue has its own scheduling algorithm. Generally, we applied round robin for foreground and first come first serve for background. Now, scheduling must be done between these queues. And this is obviously that we have to give a certain amount of time to this foreground or background, or we can assign some priority that firstly you have to process the foreground processes and then you can go on background. So first thought process was do a fixed priority scheduling. As we are much interested in the interactive processes, right? As I am telling you that I am your foreground process, I am speaking something. So you are pretty much interested in foreground only. So not bothered about background, what is happening in my background. So we can assign a fixed priority scheduling. There was a thought that we can assign a fixed priority. Firstly, go for foreground, then we will go for background. Then what will happen? Again, there is a problem if there are a number of foreground interactive processes are coming. You are just giving them whole time of CPU, and what happened for the background, they are still waiting for their turn. So what happened in this, we assign that you have to serve firstly all the foreground process, then you can go for only background process. So again, there is a possibility of starvation. To cater this problem of starvation, we have come up with the idea of multi-level queue. Now again, if you are applying this fixed priority scheduling, then there is also a problem of starvation. Then there is the sit and think about some more ideas how to solve this problem of starvation. Then they have come up with another idea. They have decided a time slice. They said, okay, we are not doing this rigid scheduling that firstly you have to go for foreground, then only you can go for background. Now what we will do, we will provide you a time slice, like 80% of time we will give you for the foreground, that is interactive processes. Then rest of the time which is remaining, we will give it to the background. Now, as we are much interested in foreground, that is why lion's share has been given to the foreground processes and the rest of the share is given to the background process. So what happened in time slice, each queue gets a certain amount of CPU time which it can schedule among its processes. Now, how we are assigning? We are giving 80% as per general rule, 80% to foreground in round robin queue and for 20% to background in FCFS queue, that is first come first serve. So now they in multi-level queue, how to schedule between foreground and background? They firstly have the idea of fixed priority scheduling, but they found there is a problem of starvation. So they come up with another idea like time slice. Okay, don't go for that rigid scheduling. Be flexible, give some amount of time to the foreground process and rest of the time to the background process. So here is a diagrammatic example to let you understand how this separate queues can work in a ready queue. Within that ready queue, you can see that in highest priority process are top of that and the low priority process are in below. So how you can see that highest priority, you can think of any system process, interactive processes, interactive editing process, batch process, and in the last, that is the student process. This is just for representation purpose, to just get you have an imagination that how we can bifurcate a single ready queue into multiple queues so that you have a fair idea that we can, as you can see that there are multiple queues, we can apply multiple algorithm on separate queues, right? Like in each queue, we can have a different algorithm based upon our requirement. So in multi-level queue, what happened that you are having a time of 80% and 20%. Still, they are rigid with their timing of like 80% for foreground process and the 20% for the background process. But in a real time scenario, we have seen that we cannot again go that rigid, that 80% time given to foreground and 20% to your background process. So there is another idea of multi-level feedback queue concept. What it is, you have seen, you can see there that in a multi-level queue, in between we have put a word like feedback. What is the meaning of this multi-level feedback queue? What we are going to do here right now, that that suppose there are multiple queues are there. This is high priority and this is then low and this is a very low priority process is there. Now, if suppose firstly we have a interactive process, we have given this in first queue and suppose it is taking too much time, then we send it to the next priority level queue. And suppose it is taking here too much time, then it will send it to the lowest priority. And in this manner, what we are doing, we are demoting a process in this manner. Means this one was the highest priority one, but if it is taking too much time, we are demoting it to the lowest queue. And in the same manner, if a process in the lowest queue is waiting for too much time, we can increase its priority by sending it to the upper queue. And suppose here it also is waiting, then we will send it to the upper queue. This manner we can implement the aging. That is the solution of the problem of starvation. So this is another idea put to make it more flexible. This is called multi-level feedback queue. So let's see what are its concept. Multi-level feedback queue. A process can move between the various queues. This flexibility was not there in the multi-level queue. They are fixed with their separation that, okay, I am interactive process, I will be in the foreground. They said, okay, you are rest of the process are batch process, you will in the background. When your time will come of 20%, you will be executed. Rest 30% of time, this will be executed. But we cannot be so rigid in this scenario because some process may be in the low priority, need some resources, otherwise they will be starved. So there is a flexibility in the multi-level feedback queue. What is the flexibility? That a process can move between the queues. That is, a batch process can move to the interactive process for after some time, and an interactive process can move into the batch process if it is not working right now. Suppose I'm giving an example that MS Word document I'm not using right now. That was in the interactive process queue, but I am not interacting right now. So that will be sent it to this background process queue. In this manner, rest of the ready queue is free so that I am using my Microsoft presentation, my Zoom application, and my headphone. That is also an application running on this laptop. So this is how a process can move between the various queues, and aging can be implemented in this manner. As you can see that we are moving between the priority queues. So here is top priority, then there is low, then there is very low. We can move between these queue. So aging can be implemented in this manner. And we need a multi-level feedback queue scheduler to implement this multi-level feedback queue scheduling algorithm. What is this multi-level feedback queue scheduler? It is defined by the following parameters. It needs certain parameters to implement this multi-level feedback queue. What are the parameters are required by this? First one, it has to be understand beforehand that what are the number of queues. Means how many number of queues are there in which it has to schedule. Second one, in each queue, which type of algorithm you are going to implement. That has to be told to this multi-level feedback queue scheduler. Next one is you must have an method and an algorithm to determine when to upgrade a process. What is the meaning of upgrading? Means if a low priority process is waiting for too much time, then you can upgrade it to the upper queue, right? If it is here also waiting for too much time, you can upgrade it to the top level, means top priority queue. So there must be a method, means after how much time you will increase its priority so that it can go for execution. So there must be a method to determine when to upgrade a process. And then we have also need to understand when we have a method to determine a process to demote. Means you need a method to determine when to demote a process. Just like we must have a criteria when to upgrade a process, similarly we must have an idea, a scheme beforehand when to demote a process. Means suppose a process is taking too much time from the foreground process, then we will send it to the background process to demote it. And in the last, a method used to determine which queue a process will enter when that process needs service. Suppose you have multiple queues you have designed, like suppose you have said that a very interactive processes will go in round robin technique, and we will give a very small time slice. Suppose 5 time slice we have given to top level Q0, and then we have another queue Q1, we have given them 10 millisecond for round robin, and then in the last we are having an FCFS queue Q2. We are giving what there is no time slot in FCFS. So what happened here? when a process arrives, you find out that what is the burst time of it. Suppose if it is having a 50 millisecond burst time, now you have to decide in which your queue you will send it, like Q0, Q1, or Q2. As you can see, that Q0 have a time slice of what, 5 millisecond only. So if you think about the context switch, that for a 50 millisecond you are having 5, then there are 10 context switches are there, right? And similarly, if it is go for 10 millisecond, then Q, that is Q1, it will have 5 context switches. Then you will find out what will be the context switch time, what is the latency of context switch, and if it is so much, means it is greater than your time quantum, then it is not very useful for you. So there are many constraints. You will decide that which queue that a process will arrive whenever it need a service. So let's see in next. There is an example to let you understand what I am telling you before. Suppose we are having a Q0, which is having a round robin technique with a time quantum of 8 millisecond, and then we have a Q1 in middle, which is also is having round robin technique with a time quantum of 16 millisecond, and in the last we are having an FCFS queue. You are imagining this is are the bifurcation of the ready queue. In a ready queue, we are having these kind of things, like first one is quantum with 8 for highly interactive processes. Then we are having given a 16 millisecond time quantum, and then FCFS. So think about a scenario. Suppose a process arrive in the ready queue. Firstly, you have given it to the highest priority, that is Q0, and it is suppose having a 50 millisecond of burst time. Now it is, and there are multiple processes are there. First P1 comes in this Q0, and it execute for 8 millisecond. You have given them charge for 8 millisecond, but as you can see that it was having the burst time of 50 millisecond. So 50 minus 8, that is 42 millisecond is still remaining. So what it will do, it will send it to this Q1. You can see here that there is an feedback arrow to send it to the Q1. Now here it will execute for 16 millisecond, and rest of the execution will be feedback it to the last queue. So in this manner, this queue is empty that time, and this is also empty, and it is running in the background, and a new process can enter in this Q0 and then Q1 also. So this manner we can have a highly flexible environment for execution of all the processes arriving, so that they can have the resources of the CPU as a fair manner. And another example, suppose a process arrive with a 4 millisecond burst time only, then it arrives here in this Q0, and you can see a time quantum is 8 milliseconds. So it will finish execution within its time quantum allotted, so it will be sent outside. And suppose we are having a process with 16 millisecond arrives here, then 8 will be executed in Q0, then it feedback it to this Q1. Here rest of the 8 millisecond will be executed, and it will be finished execution, right? And there was example of 15 millisecond, that 8 will be executed here, and then 16, and rest of the execution will be done in the FCFS manner. But here, what will happen when you will come to this Q1? Once Q0 is empty, only then Q1 will be executed. Q1 has to wait until Q0 is empty, because this is having the highest priority. If Q0 is having some process, only Q0 will be executed, because it is on the highest priority. Understand, these queues cannot execute simultaneously, because resource is only one, that is your CPU. So execution part is done for only one queue at a time. So how it is implemented, that if you want to execute a high priority process, go for Q0, else it will send it to the Q1. That will be executed only then if Q0 is empty. Similarly, this Q2, that is FCFS, that is batch process, will be execute in CPU if Q0 and Q1 are empty. So this is how multi-level feedback queue concept works. For this, what is the scheduling? What I am telling you, that the scheduler first execute all process in the Q0. Means in Q0, firstly all the process will become, and then process in Q1 will be executed only if Q0 is empty. means Q0 is having the highest priority. Firstly, it has to be finished execution of all the processes arriving in the Q0. If Q0 is empty, then Q1 will be executed. So this is what the scheduling criteria. Processes in Q1 will be executed only if Q0 is empty, right? And then similarly, process in Q2, that is this FCFS1 process in Q2 will be executed only if Q0 and Q1 are empty, right? So process in Q2 will be executed only if Q0 and Q1 are empty. So a process that arrives for Q1 will preempt a process in Q2. Suppose a process is coming for this Q1 for execution, then it will, what will it will do? It will preempt a process which is running in the FCFS. Suppose there was no process for Q0 and Q1, and then this Q2 queue process was running, but a process arrived for Q1, it will preempt the process of this FCFS because this is having the highest priority than FCFS. And similarly, what will happen if a process arrives for this Q0? It will preempt a process which is currently running by the Q1 because Q0 is having the highest priority. So in this manner, we try to put a flexible system to give a fair chance to all the processes to execute properly and have a fair share of the CPU for the execution. So this is the concept of multi-level queue and multi-level feedback queue. So let me revise you today's class once again. What we have seen in multi-level queue concept, in multi-level queue, a ready queue is partitioned into separate queues into bifurcation, foreground, that is interactive process, and the background, which is a batch process. Each queue has its own scheduling algorithm. For foreground, we apply round robin as general, and in background, we are having first come, first serve. Now, scheduling must be done between the queues. So how to schedule between these foreground and background queues? We have an idea of firstly, which was the rigid fixed priority scheduling, in which we said that firstly, you have to go to serve for all the foreground process and then go for background process. So again, there is a issue of starvation, because if you are working on full time on the foreground process, if they are coming again and again, and then all the background process has to wait. And there is a situation of starvation. So there is another idea of time slice. They given a fixed time slice of CPU, that is 80% to the foreground in a round robin manner and 20% to the background in a FCFS manner. So they try to give time that 80% of time you can go for interactive process for execution and 20% of time for the background process to get execution. But still, there is not a flexibility that you can go beyond 20% if it required some more time, it has to wait. So we come up with another idea, which is called multi-level feedback queue concept. In this multi-level feedback queue, what we will do, we give them flexibility to move between the queues that we have derived into the ready queue with help of so that we can implement the concept of aging. Means we can increase the priority of the processes gradually, or we can have an also flexibility to demote them in a lower priority process if we are not working on those processes right now. So what is the concept of multi-level feedback queue? A process can move between the various queues. In this manner, we can implement the aging. Aging is a solution of starvation. What is aging? In Viva, you may be asked that give me a solution of starvation that we have seen in multiple places, like in FCFS also, like there was a convoy effect and there is a shortage of first, there was a starvation issue. Multiple CPUs, you have CPU scheduling algorithm, you have seen the problem of starvation. Then where you can apply this aging, what is the solution of this starvation problem? Then you can say that we can gradually increase the priority of those processes to give them a threshold value get to the CPU for the execution. So this process is called aging. Aging means you are increasing the age so that it can have maturity as to go for the execution. So now multi-level feedback queue scheduler, there, as we know, there is always a scheduler which schedule all those processes. For multi-level feedback queue, we also need another separate scheduler which can schedule between these multiple queues of ready queue that we have. So what are the essential parameters that a multi-level feedback queue scheduler required? That are, firstly, we have to understand that how many number of queues are there that we have in the ready queue, means separate queue that we have designed, and which type of algorithm we are going to implement in each queue, and what is the method or your scheme on which basis you are promoting a process or upgrading a process, means you are increasing its age, or what is the method or an scheme on which basis you are demoting a process or decreasing its priority. And there is also, you need a method which will decide that, like, there are multiple queues, in which queue you want to send your process when firstly it arrives in the ready queue for execution in the CPU. So what are the parameters? First one is number of queues, second one scheduling algorithm for each queue, then method used to determine when to upgrade a process, method used to determine when to demote a process, method used to determine which queue a process will enter when that process needs service. Now, this is a very important topic that will comes in your examination very frequently. They ask about, tell me the what are the parameters that a multi-level feedback queue scheduler require to schedule between multiple queues of a ready queue in a multi-level feedback queue environment. Then you have to list out these methods, like number of queues, scheduling algorithm, and these are the parameters, like what are the number of queues, scheduling algorithm for each queue, methods used to determine when to upgrade a process, when to demote a process, and a scheme or method which will decide that in which queue you will send firstly if a process arrives in the ready queue. So here is an example that suppose we are having three queue, Q0 that is having a time quantum of 8, then we have a Q1 with the time quantum of 16 millisecond, and then we have a FCFS in the last. So what is the scheduling we are implementing here? The scheduler first execute all processes in Q0, right? And then process in Q1 will be executed only if Q0 is empty, because Q1 is having lesser priority than Q0. Now, similarly, process in Q2 will be executed only if Q0 and Q1 are empty. Means firstly, highest priority is given to Q0, then Q1 is there, so Q0 has to be empty, Q1 has to be empty, then there is a chance of this Q2, right? So a process that arrives for Q1 will preempt a process in Q2, and a process that arrives for Q0 will preempt a process in Q1. So this is the concept of multi-level feedback queue, which is actually implemented in computer systems, because we need a flexible system which can identify when to send a process into foreground, when to send a process in the background. And the thing is, we need a flexible system in which all processes need a fair share, get a fair share of the CPU for the execution of their activity, whatever they required, whatever the hardware they required, they can have, so that no process can starve. So we are stopping our class right here. Okay, so in next class, we will have some more topics.